Hey, hey, I'm Dr. Nashley Cephas, and I'm a principal AI scientist at Amazon Web Services. Today, we're here at Pearl Salon Suites. My girl, Shaniqua, is gonna give me a twist-up hairstyle. Also, we're gonna talk about generative AI and how she can use it for her business. So come on.
Hey, Ashley, how are you?
I know you're like taking over the world with your salon suites.
I know, I'm like one location after another. Our salon suites is created for anyone who's in the beauty profession. It's a turnkey space without the overhead.
What are some of the challenges that you face?
Some of our biggest pain points in general would be visibility, the website, and some of the SEOs. All right, Miss Nashley, I think you are all set and you got your twist up. It looks good.
Awesome, I think so too. So in terms of the generative AI solutions, I think we can help with a few things.
I'm so excited for you to show me what we can do.
So here we have PartyRock, which is a playground for Amazon's Bedrock, which is our generative AI tool. It allows you to create different apps on the fly in a matter of minutes. Let's start with an app that I created called a blogger app.
Okay.
To help with some of the actual content to help improve your SEO. You have something in mind or?
Yeah, recently a beauty professional was asking me about ways to establish her LLC or knowing which structure to use.
Opening paragraph. If you're looking to open your own beauty service business, one great option is renting a salon suite at Pearl Salon Suites.
So, it picked up Pearl Salon Suites?
Yeah. I wrote this one, tailored it to put on your website. So it's already plugging in your business for them. So an LLC, it explains what it is. It talks about your tax situation, your credit, keeping your business finances separate. You see it's already bulleting everything out. So it's already giving you a lot of good details for your users. You notice that there's different AI models that you can use with this tool. So the different models speak differently. You'll also notice that there's three little blocks here. Right. This just means how computationally intense the model is. So if you want something more quicker, you use something with less blocks.
That's great, Nashley. Like, I'm really wow, this is really cool.
It is cool. I think it's a good point to bring up. It's not magic. You have to make sure the human in the loop is using the AI responsibly and that you're actually going back and checking.
Now you have my mind thinking about how this can apply just in other spaces.
I love you say you're thinking about different ways you can use it. That's why we're here. So thanks so much for your time.
Nashley was able to show me how to optimize my SEOs for our website and bring more awareness and online presence for our business.
What I did to prep for this was to go into PartyRock and give a suggestion on the type of app that I want to create. It just really shows how easy, once you have an idea, it pretty much does all the hard work for you.
I was really blown away of how easy it was to use and customize it and tweak it to our business.
Three main points I want to leave you with. One, the quality of the output depends on the prompt that you enter as the input. Secondly, there are so many different models you can use and they're being updated as we speak. Lastly, AI is not perfect. So remember, be sure you're aware of the intended use cases that you can create. PartyRock is free. All you have to do is visit partyrock.aws, sign up with an account, and get started. Now, what do you want an app to do?
Everything. I'm just teasing.
No, that one will take a little bit longer.
Right.